Hello Windows Universe, in this video we will talk about if Windows 10 deactivates itself after updates. For a more in-depth look at the topic, we will link an article in the description down below. The most basic fix is to use a product key. The key can be one previously used on the PC before the Windows installation. If the key cannot be found, it might be embedded in the BIOS firmware. We will have to use a particular command in the command prompt to find it. Open the command prompt, type in WMIC space path software licensing service space git space OA3X original product key and hit enter. Once the key is found, open settings, go to Update and Security, click on Activation. You'll have a button that will show up that says Enter Product Key. Click on it and enter the product key in the pop-up box. The Windows 10 Activation Troubleshooter can address most common activation on Windows devices. Now, if your version of Windows in 1607 or later has previously been activated, then the Windows Activation Troubleshooter doesn't appear for you. Now, if you haven't activated yet, then you can go to Settings, go to Update and Security, go to Activation. If Windows Activation Troubleshooter is available, it will show up in the top. If you've just put in this version of Windows, if you've just updated to this version of Windows, then another fix could be to roll back to a previous version of Windows. You have about 10 days to do this. So if it's been less than 10 days, you can go to Settings, you can go to Update and Security, Recovery. If it has been less than 10 days, then you should have the option to roll back to a previous version of Windows. If, however, that 10-day period has passed, you do not have this option. If these options are not available to you or you just can't get it to work, then there's a pre-installed customer support app in Windows that may be able to help in this situation. Go to the taskbar and type in Help. Click on Get Help and just follow the command prompts. For instance, Windows. You find recommended articles that can potentially help. If that doesn't help, then you can click No and click Contact. Under the Contact part, you'll be able to chat with what's called a virtual agent. Do things like select your product, and it will take you through a step-by-step problem-solving tour. If the virtual agent can help you resolve the issue, it will. Otherwise, eventually, you will end up with a human representative to talk to. For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel where we are always adding new content. Thanks for watching and have a great day.